Hi, Jeff Frick from SiliconANGLE and theCUBE. We are on the ground at the Sheraton Palace, San Francisco for BrightEdge Share 14. There's a lot going on, SEO optimization. So we're here joined here by Brad Madlick, or excuse me, Maddock, VP Product and Marketing. Just came off the keynote. Welcome. Yeah.
Thanks for having me today. Excited to be here.
So a ton of energy in the keynote. Jim was going bananas, Jim the CEO.
Yeah.
The room was packed.
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about the conference, how long you've been doing this, how many people are here, give us an update.
Yeah, definitely. So Share 14 is a conference that we've been hosting for 4 years now, always in San Francisco. This year we've got about 1,000 attendees focused on organic search and content performance marketing. And when we built the program, one of the things we were inspired by was our experience building Dreamforce at Salesforce. So we built a program around our community where the content comes from the community, where big brands are sharing real case studies and best practices in a way that has a repeatable playbook for everyone here.
So content marketing is all the rage, right? Everyone wants to do it. Nobody's reading white papers anymore. So you guys have a really unique perspective. You've been playing this game for a while. So what are some of the secrets to content marketing? Why is it important to brands and customers?
Yeah, it's a great question. We definitely have a different perspective. And the way I'd put it is this. A lot of content marketing is tweeting out selfies. It's putting out pictures of yourself. There's your content, or maybe a video. And that's just not going to pay the bills. It's not going to make a difference. So our view on content marketing is it needs to be content performance marketing. It needs to be about measuring the results and knowing it's going to have an impact. So we announced a ton of technology today to help marketers measure the results and the impact of their content as they're producing it.
So you've been at it for a while. So talk a little bit about the change in the scene from big data, the rise of big data, the focus on big data. You know, people want to collect everything now, including the selfie pictures. And then also mobile, the other huge trend as things are moving more and more to mobile and how that's impacting your business and more importantly, your customer's business.
Yeah, so you know, it's interesting. Being a software company today, we're also a big data company. So we have so much data that we look at for content performance marketing. We're looking at analytics data from customers. We integrate with our customers and partners, Facebook and Twitter. We also pull in a lot of our own data directly in the BrightEdge platform. So fundamentally, we're a big data company. Part of our technology, we call the Data Cube. And so when you think about content and all the things you have to measure, we're processing massive volumes of data in real time. And you know, none of this was possible. So 10 years ago, when I was at Salesforce, we couldn't do any of this stuff. We had one big honking server with one Oracle database. It's all different now. It's all MapReduce. It's all commodity hardware on Amazon, EC3, and others. So now the speed at which you can go through data, process results, and provide insights is just unbelievable.
Well, so let's talk a little bit about more of that real time, right? We always talk about real time and what is real time? Is a fire alarm going off? It's we're live, as you could tell.
Yep.
So
I think we broke the fire
code.
It's big that the fire marshal's coming in. I may have to talk to him.
I'm blaming Jim. I think he's putting off the heat himself. The guy's excited. But let's talk a little bit about that because now I lost my train of thought. Where were we going with this?
Real time,
you know, what is real time? You know, usually real time is in time to make a difference on the transaction, not to lose the customer. Mm-hmm. So how do you guys define real time and what are you seeing in the marketplace in terms of customers trying to implement real time decision making and changes based on your tools?
Yeah. We see a couple things. The first thing is the speed at which folks can get started using the technology and getting benefit from it. So we built a lot in our business to optimize how folks get started. We've optimized ourselves in a way. And so we have a dedicated onboarding team we call Ignite that gets people up and running. But then within the platform, we make sure that everything happens in real time. So if you want to go and discover data, if you want to look at what's happening in your business, what's driving results, all that's designed to work in real time in our cloud infrastructure.
That's awesome. So, and then the last thing, search engine optimization, right? It used to be talked about all the time, you know, how do you game Google? Mm-hmm. Clearly the game's changed a lot. Also, no one even searches on Google anymore. We type our search into our browser bar, obviously the rise of Bing. Wonder if you could give us an update on how search engine optimization is changing and how it really needs to integrate within your content marketing strategy.
Yeah, definitely. So the way that I think about search engine optimization, search is the user interface of the internet. If you've got a product or service to sell, you're going to find more potential customers through search than any other mechanism. That's how people typically are discovering your content. And what's happened with Google's leadership and Bing's leadership is organic search optimization has completely changed. For a while, it was like email in the early days. It was spam, send the spam, web spam. And I think now what's happening is brands are really investing and focusing on that channel. You know, we just announced research today that shows that across all the industries we look at, organic search is by far the largest driver of traffic for every brand we've encountered. And so what that means, if you're a marketer, you have to treat organic search as a first-class marketing channel and manage it like a business.
So Brad, I'm sure you're excited. You're releasing a lot of stuff. You've probably been working really hard for this day. So for the folks that aren't here, give us a little bit of what you're announcing, some of the new things that are happening at the show.
Yeah, I'll tell you about a couple things I'm super excited about. The first one is within our Data Cube, which is our big data store, we've added new functionality. The one I'm most excited about we call Data Cube Time Machine. So if you think about it, we crawl the entire web and collect billions of pieces of content and keywords and demand every single month. And now you can go back and forth in time and trend that out. So if you're a marketer and you want to understand history to drive results in the future, we do that for you directly in the platform. We just announced that. The other thing that I'm super excited about, you know, we looked out on LinkedIn. There are over 2 million people that focus on content marketing today. And we realized while we announced 1,000 customers today, there's a lot of people out there that need great technology. So we also just announced our Community Edition, which is a free product. We're giving away our most powerful technology, Data Cube and Content Optimizer, to enable the whole community to succeed at content marketing.
So then what's different from the Community Edition than the Enterprise Edition?
It's a great question. Community Edition is an extension in your Chrome browser, so you can take the Data Cube and you can take Content Optimizer with you to go as you browse. The full version of the platform, you can slice, you can dice, you can pivot, you can do all those things.
Excellent. So Brad Maddock, VP Product and Marketing, is really excited. We're Share 14. Thanks for watching SiliconANGLE.tv. I'm Jeff Frick.